Hello all, let's check out another mod in a Space Engineer Spotlight.
Okay, today in today's mod spotlight, we're going to start with the GPS waypoint system. So we're going to throw that in here, and I have a sandbox world ready to load. Alright, so how this works is press enter, and you type in waypoint, add, and a name you want to call it. So we're going to call this base. If you hit enter, it puts it exactly where you're standing. So see in the bottom left hand corner, location is negative 23, negative 1000, and positive 300. If you look at the top of the screen, it says GPS and waypoint system. Now those numbers pretty much coincide with the numbers that showed up in chat. So that's kind of how that works. So the cool part about this is you can do stuff like this, if I get this right. So we go waypoint, add, north. I have no idea if that's actually north or not. And then you can type in enemy, neutral, or allied. I'm going to do enemy so it shows up red. That'll be kind of cool. And, well, you can go really far out there. It's, what is it, 1 billion kilometers? No, 1 trillion kilometers. Billion or trillion? Pretty far, either way. So let's go 1, 2, 3, space, 0, space, 0. And in theory, if I did this right, it's going to go out 1 million kilometers from here on the X plane and put an enemy beacon called north. Not enough parameters. Let's see, I did it wrong. Text on HUD. Oh, okay. So hit enter, hit up, which is kind of cool that you can actually use the one that you were just using before. It basically wants what you're going to call the waypoint and then what it's going to show up on the waypoint, like so. There's one bit added. Oh, it must have been showed up for them. So let's try doing that again. Like I said, I haven't used this one yet, so allied. Waypoint has been added for allied. So in the Let's Play environment, I went 100,000 for these. So this is a test that you can't see them from that far away. So, well, there we go. So we have now deemed that north. So I can go like this, and now you can also go over here and type remove north, and it'll remove it from. Actually, it looks like it removed all waypoints it added. So those three enemy ones that we, or the two enemy ones we added as well. So we're gonna do this again. Waypoint. Actually, why type when it's already typed? We're going to add a zero. So it's visible to 500,000. We saw it pop up behind it, so I'm going to call this 3. And do 1, 5. Okay, so that does not show up. So at least let's try something here. Waypoint remove north. Do we do it right? I think so. So, but it didn't remove them. Okay. Interesting. So we're learning together here, folks. So that's the synopsis of this. You get these cool little waypoints. They're basically, it looks like you're using the glowy effect from the beacons. So if we drop a beacon next to it, it should look pretty similar. Yeah, I see. Same glowy effect as the beacon. That's pretty cool. You can remove them, and you can do not that, but this waypoint toggle, and it turns them off. That's pretty cool. I didn't see anything in the instructions on toggling specific ones, because you can put, let's toggle them back on. So I'm gonna put one here to waypoint add, and we'll call this one or, and it just adds it where you add if you don't put coordinates in it. So we add another one. I'm gonna do neutral. Actually, we're gonna do allied. Okay. When you get more descriptive, it wants more. So now it should just put it at our current location. Or I screwed it up, typing or something. Waypoint, add, base. And then XYZ. So I have to add XYZ because I'm not allowing it to use a generic. So luckily up at the top of the screen, there is the XYZ there. Like so. Now let's put one over here. Now we're going to call this one bad guys. And we'll see if that shows up or if it's just going to show up just for them. Enemy 292, 106, and we're obviously moving on the Z plane, the Z plane. Okay, so they do show up. All right. So I did not find a way to be able to toggle between neutral. So if I do the toggle. Like that. See how they all went away. So let's try it, shall we? Toggle enemy. Yeah, see, that doesn't work. I'm hiding waypoints from group enemy. Oh yeah, see, type toggle enemy to display them. Okay, it does say that. What am I doing wrong? Let's try the name of that. Yeah, see, that didn't work. Let's try the one we know that does work, base. And no, that one didn't show up either. Okay, so let's try toggling. Let's try hitting enter first. Waypoint toggle. They're all on. Okay. So let's try waypoint toggle. Or. Yeah, see? It doesn't work. It looks like it's there, just not working properly. So I see that being kind of useful. Especially if they're grouped, like by names. You could put or space iron as a display name, you know, or like a little dash, because I think space would be delineating the next line of code. So or dash, so something like this. Waypoint add or iron. So it puts this here. So I think it'd be cool is if we toggle, or if you were able to use these and then toggle the ore ones on and off, or the rest of them on and off that you used in the system. Like I said, it looks like it's there in this in the code. It's just not working. So waypoint toggle ore. Yeah, it's not turning them on and off, but waypoint toggle still works, which is cool in itself. So let's see. So yeah, all of them got turned off. So that's that. So that's the waypoint GPS system. It's pretty slick. You can pretty much, it looks like they're just shy of a million units out. You can see them. I guess we really didn't definitively test the distance we can go on that. Let's see here. And that's as far back as we can go in the typing queue. So that's pretty cool. So waypoint add. So I'm going to put 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. And then these are going to be 0. So 0 space 0. Can't see that one. Okay. So we're going to delete one of those. Delete one of those. Science at its best right here, people. This is for science. And they're not showing up. So they must be just out of range. Another cool thing about this is I don't think... Yeah, we don't have an antenna. Wrong button. So we're going to delete that. So that's out of here. There's no antenna here. There's nothing here but a block. That's 3,000 units away-ish. And even still, I'm wondering. Can you sniper? No, you can't. Okay. I don't play much in creative mode, so... I think the only time I'm in creative mode is when I want to do stuff like, this. So, and we're not quite sure. Let's see here. Let's play that a little bit more here. We put add base allied. That should be showing up. Oh, there we go. It is. Okay, so I could have sworn we had one at 500,000. So, waypoint remove base. So we're going to remove all those. Oh, again, I'm typing. That's 500,000. And there it is. Okay. To go to 900,000, and it's there. But if we go to 1,000,000, it's not there. So looks like we'll just back it off. I'm guessing, this is a guess, like I said, we're going over this together for the first time. So it looks like just short of 1,000,000 out there. It's there. So that's still pretty far. I mean, the math of how long it would travel to get there, that's pretty crazy. I went out 100,000 on our Let's Play series, and that took 45 minutes, I think, of flight time to get back. That's why it ended up being a cut in between. So, all right. So that's our GPS waypoint system. So if there's things you want me to try out with this mod, questions or anything like that, I'm going to put a link to the Steam Workshop from the creator of this mod. So if you want to know who made it or anything like that, you can go ahead and check out the link below. And all right. Hope you like the mod spotlights. Let's have it. Later.